Hi, it's me, Stevie, Si Tai Fu again. Today I'm going to show you guys how to make a strong, fizzy, and tasty kombucha. These are the previous batch I did. Try take a look how fizzy it is. For kombucha brewing, the ingredients are pretty simple. You need to have 1.5 cup of sugar, 8 of those black tea bag. In fact, you can use many kinds of tea leaves. Some of those they use green tea, you know, but for me, I prefer black tea. But for kombucha brewing, things can be very simple and straightforward if you have SCOBY. And what is SCOBY actually? It is the cultivated yeast. Some people call it bacteria, okay? Okay, let me show you what is this SCOBY all about. It's like a kind of jellyfish in appearance, I mean. So let me take it out. You have a look. See. Yeah. For every time you brew a kombucha, make sure you leave about 2 cups of the starter tea. Okay, the original kombucha from your previous brew. So that to make the yeast able to absorb the shock, if you put on the new black tea, so perhaps it's not able to take the environment. This SCOBY is 1 year old. I started in a very tiny SCOBY, which is given by my sister Catherine, and now you can see it's growing like a hamburger. Actually, you can grow your own SCOBY. I mean, from the original kombucha, you can cultivate it. It will take about 2 weeks, maybe. The process you can find in any YouTube channel. So I will boil a 1 liter of water over here. And then for this jar, I will put 2.5 liter. So the starter tea, I have 1 liter, means a total about 4.5 liter. That should be all right. Okay, the water is boiling now. We should dump our tea bag in and boil it for 20 minutes. Okay, yes, past 20 minutes, let's off the fire and remove the tea bag. You should place the brewing jar soaked with the water in a container so it's fastened the cooling process. We'll wait for about 1 hour, let it cool down to the room temperature. The best temperature should be below 30 degrees because the high temperature may probably kill the SCOBY. So take note on this. Alright, the temperature of the black tea has already come to the ambient temperature. So we shall put our SCOBY in. For the first fermentation, we shall go for 10 days. Then after that, we will do bottling of our kombucha and go for the second fermentation, which will probably take 5 to 6 days. Kombucha drinks is considered one of the good natural probiotic drinks. So it's good for our digestive system. It helps in better nutrient absorption by our small intestine. So it's really bring great benefits, I mean. And lastly, you need to cover the opening with a piece of cloth, okay, clean cloth or maybe cheesecloth. And just put a rubber band. That's it.
Today is the fifth day of the fermentation. Look at the SCOBY. It's actively fermented. You can see the bubble over here. There are plenty of CO2 gases released, and it pushed the SCOBY up. You can see over here. So the top one is quite dry right now. So I need to flip the SCOBY. If not, the SCOBY will die. If you have a thin SCOBY, you can just leave it like this. But make sure you wash your hand thoroughly before you do this process.
When it comes to flavoring your kombucha for the secondary, basically there are a few options, okay? You can basically use apple, you can use peach, you can use passion fruit, you can use cherry. For me, I will choose a pineapple. Okay, bear in mind that choose those with stem. Okay, I'm going to show you the much easier way to cut the pineapple, especially with stem. Okay. Mentioned about choose the pineapple with stem, right? So that is the reason why, because you know you do not have a direct contact your hand onto the flesh of the fruits. If you touch the pineapple, you know your hand will feel like, I don't know what it's called in English, but in Cantonese we call it wat san san.
What?
You know, maybe yeah, it's something like slippery. I don't know what's the English word. Okay, now come to the hardest part. You need to cut the eye of the pineapple, which is taking a little bit of time. So you can notice that with this stem, I can hold it and make things much more easier when you do the cutting. So bear in mind, okay? Look at that. It's nicely done. So right now we can cut into pieces and then put in the blender to blend it. You need to shift it up. We just need the liquid, not the sediment, right? So just using the coffee strainer. look at this, the sediment, I call it, it's actually the fiber. You wouldn't want to put it inside the bottle, so to make your kombucha smooth. Okay, if you are using the swing top bottle, like me, so the flavoring should go at this level. That should be sufficient. Okay. So now we are going to put our kombucha in this bottle. Today is day 10 of the fermentation. So primary should consider done. And now we need to bottle our kombucha. Please remember to reserve 2 cups of this kombucha for your next brew. Okay, we call it as a starter tea. Remove your SCOBY first. It's so thick, you know. Look at that. Take a look at this SCOBY, which is 1 year ago. Look how small it is. And now, it becomes so thick. Make a little stir before you collect 2 cups of kombucha. This will be our next batch. For the secondary fermentation of the kombucha, so we leave it sit for 5 days before we can taste it. One thing also I would like to highlight over here. If you can notice that I leave quite a plenty of headroom. They have a room for expansion when the CO2 gas release, you know, during the second fermentation. This is important. We do not want to explode our bottle. Today is the 4th day of our fermentation. Try to take a look over here for the huge bubble formation. I can't really wait to taste my kombucha now. Let's put in the fridge for a couple hours and let's try it out. Here you go guys. Tasting time for our kombucha. Look at the fizziness. Whoa! Whoa! Wow, 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 wow. Look at that, look at that. Whew. Oh my God. How awesome it is. Look at my kombucha. Strong, fizzy, tasty kombucha, guys. Wow, it's simply awesome. Can you see that? Guys, Merry Christmas. It's around the corner. I'm here to wish you guys a happy Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Okay, please subscribe to my channel. I have plenty more nice and awesome brewing videos to show you guys. Stay tuned. Peace.